Hi, James Hargreaves here from Richmond Music School. Today we are going to be counting down the top 10 greatest guitar solos by British guitarists from the 1990s. Not all of these solos have been chosen for their flashiness or for their technical wizardry. That's the kind of stuff you got in the 1980s. In Britain in the 1990s, you did get some of that, and you'll see some of that towards the top of the list, but a hallmark of a great solo in the 1990s was its melody, its clear tone, its beauty was a big part of it. So some of these solos, they're not the most complicated solos in the world, but they're melodic, they're memorable, and they fit perfectly in the song. And one other thing that is probably worth mentioning is that because this is going to be a huge video, the most ambitious one I've tried yet, I'm going to have to film it over a process of a couple of weeks. So expect my beard to grow, my hair to look different, and my clothes to look different. Well, it took me more than a couple of weeks, it took me a month, but I've done it. My hair looks the same, my beard looks the same, there are new pictures on the walls, and there's another amp up on the stack over there. Other than that, we're good to go, so here we go. So, in at number 10 we have Chasing Rainbows by Shed 7, a fantastic Yorkshire band. This is a quite easy solo performed by Paul Banks, who also wrote the song. It's taken from the album Let It Ride, and this was released on the 4th of November 1996, and it got to number 17 in the UK. This is a really nice beginner's solo, very melodic, fits the song perfectly. I still remember the first time I heard Chasing Rainbows by Shed 7, being blown away by how much I loved the song. It's still a classic today, it still stands up, so here we go, enjoy. So, in at number 9 we have Stanley Road by Paul Weller, formerly of The Jam. This is another nice, easy solo, perhaps not as straightforward as Chasing Rainbows, but pretty easy nonetheless. Stanley Road was the title track of the album, Stanley Road, which reached number 1 in the UK and was released on the 15th of May 1995. It had a lot of good songs on it, Changing Man, Broken Stones, and various other really well-known ones, You Do Something to Me. Really nice ballad. But for me, Stanley Road, the song, was always the standout track on the album. I always loved it. And of all the tracks on that album, I think this is the best solo. So here we go. The solo from Stanley Road by Paul Weller. In at number 8 we have In a Room by Dodgy. Dodgy were based in Hounslow, down south, and this solo is performed by Andy Miller, their guitarist. It's a medium difficulty level solo, so it is a step up from the previous two. This was released on the 8th of June, 96, and got to number 12 in the UK. Now, Dodgy were a bit of a peculiar band, in my opinion. I had a couple of their CDs back in the day, and I remember listening to them and going, the singles are good. And everything else is like it was written after smoking, you know, 15 pounds of weed. So, yeah, interesting band, but the singles were great, and this was, in my opinion, the best one. Fantastic guitar solo. Here we go, from Hounslow's finest.
In at number 7, we have Hey Dude by Cooler Shaker. This London-based psychedelic rock band was fronted by guitarist Crispin Mills, who opened their first album, K, with the song Hey Dude. It's about a medium-level difficulty solo again. It's a touch more difficult than the previous one by Dodgy. This was released on the 7th of September, 96, and got to number 2, so a pretty big hit. Here we go, Hey Dude by Cooler Shaker. At number 6, it's Live Forever by Oasis. Oasis were easily the biggest band of the Brit rock movement in the 90s. They ushered in a whole new wave of guitar bands. They were at the forefront of it. And on that first album, on Definitely Maybe, which Live Forever is taken from, Noel Gallagher was at his best as a lead guitarist. On What's the Story, Morning Glory, their second album, he was at his best as a songwriter, but he'd started to slip a little as a lead guitarist. And by the time you got to their third album, Be Here Now, he was really quite preschool at his guitar playing. But on this first album, he was quite a solid lead guitarist. A lot of his lead lines are really good, and Live Forever was the high point. It's definitely the hardest Oasis solo of all of them. So I've set this at the difficulty level of hard because it's quite challenging, especially on the second half when you do the very fast runs. This was released on the 8th of August, 94, and got to number 10 in the UK. In at number 5, we have our second hard level guitar solo. This is the Manic Street Preachers with La Tristesse Dura. Help me out here, Google.
La Tristesse Dura.
I think I was somewhere close. The Manic Street Preachers pronounce it La Tristesse Dura, which is wrong. But yeah, this is performed by James Dean Bradfield, the singer and guitarist from Manic Street Preachers, and it was from their album Gold Against the Soul, which in my opinion was one of their best, absolutely fantastic album. It was released early in the 90s on the 31st of July, 93, and it got to number 22. It's a brilliant solo, it's quite challenging, you're at both ends of the neck all the time, it's very fast and fluid, but I love this solo. Here we go. Number 4, we have Ocean Colour Scene with The Riverboat Song. Now those of you who were growing up in the 90s will remember this song being played every single Friday on TFI Friday, hosted by Chris Evans, which was a TV mainstay back in the day before everyone had 5 million TV channels at their fingertips. Ocean Colour Scene were a Brummie band. They came from Birmingham. and guitarist Steve Craddock, who also played for Paul Weller, performs a really quite difficult guitar solo here on Moseley Shoals, which was their best album by a mile. This was released as a single on the 5th of February 96 and got to number 15 in the UK, but it's far and away their best known song, I think largely because of TFI Friday. Anyway, here we go. Number three, we have The Stone Roses with Breaking Into Heaven from their second album, Second Coming. Now this is our first pro-level solo. This is hard. It's been performed by guitarist John Squire, who's a bit of a guitar legend in the world of Brit rockers. And this was not a single, this was just an album track. It was released on the 5th of December 1994, and the album reached number four in the UK. It's a bit of a funny one really. The Stone Roses are a legendary group because of their first album. This second album was, it had some good moments, but it wasn't a patch on the first. It was really kind of bloated and overlong, cocaine-fueled, a bit difficult to listen to in places. I've always thought it could have been released as a brilliant EP if they'd put Breaking Into Heaven without the long rubbish intro, Love Spreads, the live version of Daybreak from Crimson Tonight, and one other album track. It would have been an absolutely epic EP. But yeah, as it is, Breaking Into Heaven is a really good song as long as you skip the nonsensical intro. And this solo is played around the 9 minutes mark, so towards the end of the song. This is the solo that plays the song out. And yeah, I hope you enjoy it. This is really hard, so if you have a go at it, give yourself some time. This is a mega, mega, mega difficult one, so here we go. Number two, we have Cast with History. This was never a single, this was just an album track from Cast's fantastic debut album, All Change, featuring guitarist Liam Tyson right hand tapping his way right through the song. Now, it's a bit of a cheat, really. This song has a guitar solo, but the song is actually basically a guitar solo from start to finish, a very difficult one, and you can't get it right without the correct delay settings and getting every note meticulously planned out. The album All Change was released on the 16th of October 1995 and got to number 7 in the UK. Now, I'm not going to play the entire song start to finish, but I'm going to pick it up from the point where the actual guitar solo starts. Then I'm going to play it through the various sections that remain, and you'll get to see one of every section of the song from that point to the end. So yeah, here we go. History by Cast. Number one, it is Love Is the Law by the Seahorses. Now, this is a bit of a cheat because it's John Squire again, the guitarist from the Stone Roses. But most Britpop, Britrock aficionados would agree this was his finest guitar moment. The Seahorses were a band who were formed in York. They're mostly York musicians with the exception of John Squire. And this was on their only album, Do It Yourself. Now, if, like me, you bought the single Love Is the Law, you thought that the song finished like this. But then, later on, when you bought the album and were listening to the song, this happened. John Squire and the band launched into a 5-minute guitar solo at the end of the song, and it was fantastic. I remember listening to it for the first time, and it was the same thing as when I saw Liam Tyson playing his guitar solo from History live. I was just blown away. It was incredible. This is nightmarishly difficult. So John Squire does this very, very, very fast tremolo picking all the way through. So a lot of the notes are lost in just turkey gobble, whacka, 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 whacka noise. So I've had to completely transcribe this myself because the book was wrong, as usual. And it's hard. This is really hard. But if you want to have a go at this, more power to you. It's 5 minutes long, and it's taken me in excess of 200 repeats to get this solo right. So here we go. Number one, Love Is the Law, John Squire.